Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about the class 5 enzymes, that is isomerases. So these isomerases catalyze interconversion of isomers. So these isomers may be structural isomers or may be optical or geometric isomers. So we know that isomers means they have a same molecular formula, but they differs with respect to their structure. So that means there will be only one substrate in this particular reaction, and this one substrate, because of intramolecular rearrangement, there will be only one product. So we can write this reaction as, suppose a molecule ABC, after isomerase catalyzed reaction, it can be converted to BAC. So they catalyze intramolecular rearrangement. So they are subclassified. If you take EC, they belong to EC 5 series. The subclassification 1, those isomerases which catalyze racemization or epimerization. So they are called racemases or epimerases. So they belong to EC 5-1 series. The example for this particular subclasses are alanine racemase. This enzyme converts L-alanine to D-alanine. The EC number for this particular enzyme is, so this is the first enzyme of this particular classification, that is 5-1-1-1. The second subclassification of isomerases, those enzyme which catalyze conversion of cis or trans isomers. So they belong to EC 5-2 series. The example for this particular enzyme is malate isomerase or malyl acetoacetate isomerase. So the first enzyme, malate isomerase. Cis isomer will be converted to trans isomers or vice versa. So those enzymes which catalyze conversion of intramolecular oxidoreduction reactions, so they are called intramolecular oxidoreductases. So don't confuse for class 1 enzyme, they are oxidoreductases. So here why they are called intramolecular oxidoreductase, within the same molecule, the electrons are transferred from the one part of the molecule to the other part of the molecule. The example here is EC5311. So the name of the enzyme, triose phosphate isomerase. So this enzyme we can see in glycolysis reaction. This group of enzyme belong to EC5-3 series. The EC5-4 series enzymes are those isomerases which convert intramolecular transfer reactions. So these enzymes are similar to class 2 transferases, but they are not transferases, because here within the substrate there will be transfer of functional group from one part of that particular substrate to the other part of the substrate. So there will be only one substrate and one product, but transfer of functional group from one part of the molecule to the other part of the molecule. So they are commonly known as mutases. So the example is phosphoglucomutase. So like this, there are many subclassifications. It will continue. Again, under enzyme class 5, the third digit 1 stands if the substrate is amino acid. If the substrate is hydroxy acid, then the third digit will be 2. If the third digit number is 3, then the substrate is carbohydrate. Triose phosphate isomerase. So this enzyme catalyzes interconversion of dihydroxyacetone phosphate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Let me write the structure of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So this is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, and there will be the rearrangement within this particular group. So there will be only one substrate and only one product. So within this group there will be rearrangement. We will see the reaction now. So that means from the CH2OH, the two hydrogen move to this second carbon atom. So one hydrogen will come here, another hydrogen will come here. So the structure will look like this now. So you can see here the carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So here also carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So there is a rearrangement here. The two hydrogen will be going to the second carbon atom, and the second carbon atom will become now CHOH. So the first carbon atom CH2OH, it will become now aldehyde group. So that is why it is called glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, catalyzed by triose phosphate isomerase. This is with respect to the class 5 enzymes isomerases. Thanks for watching.